If you need a talk over but your mixer doesn't have one, today it's your lucky day because I've got the solution for you. Hello everybody, I'm DJ Wolf from Wolf Entertainment, and today I'm going to show you a little hack in Virtual DJ. Also, at the end of the video, I have a pro tip for anybody who wants to level up not only the quality sound of the mic, but even the overall quality of the sound with a very small budget. So stay tuned until the end, subscribe to my channel for more tutorials, performances, pro tips and more awesome videos. I'm going to show you two methods how to do it, with some differences of how they work. I'm using Virtual DJ 2020, but it doesn't matter which version you have, as long as they have custom mapping. For the first method, you are going to need this script, which I found after a lot of research. I mean, a lot of research. For real, guys, I was searching more than 16 hours. Okay, maybe I was watching Netflix most of the time. But I actually found it. Of course, I will have the script in the description. Also, I'm going to explain you how you can tweak it a little bit to fit it in your needs. So let's dive in. Open Virtual DJ, load a track in each deck, go to settings, and then in controller tab. In this case, we are going to use keyboard button, but the method is exactly the same even if you have a controller. First, make sure you have selected keyboard at the left top panel, then go to key and select the button you want to use. In my case, is T. Go to action and paste the script. Save it in the little tab on top, and you are ready. Close the settings and let's try it out. Press the button you selected and check your faders. As you can see, it works like a charm. Now, let's see how it really works. You can use it in both decks with the same button. The effect works in the deck which is master, so be sure you have the right deck focused before use. You can change it from here, A, B, or from the master over here. Now, let's see how you can tweak the parameters in the script for faster or slower movement and decrease or increase of the volume. Go to settings again and let's see the script in the action panel. There are four parameters you want to tweak. First, for the amount of volume you want to decrease. In the last line, the 20% is the decreased volume you currently have. You just have to change the percentage as much as you want. Now, you can also change the increased volume percentage by going in the first line and change the 100% in whatever value you want. Save it. And let's see what we've done. Now I press T, and as you can see, it goes from 50 to 80. I don't want it like this, so let's put it again in the original values. Now, for the speed of the movement at the fader, again, in settings, at the last line in the script, there is a -5% value. Change it as you like, and obviously, this is the decreasing value. For the increasing value, go to the second line and tweak the +5% as you like. Save it, and let's see what we've done. As you can see, it goes very fast. In my humble opinion, my left stroke just went viral. Right stroke put a baby in a spiral. Soprano C, we like to keep it on the high note. You suck! After a lot of tests, I found that with the minus plus 5% for the decrease slash increase and the 100% max and 20% min is the best settings you can have. For the second method, you are going to need this script. The difference here is that it works in all channels, even in Sampler, at the same time. Also, you can change it from toggle to use it only when you press the button. Back in Virtual DJ, we open settings one more time, select a key and paste the script in action panel. You can tweak it by changing the 20%, which is the minimum level of the volume, and the 250 milliseconds, which is the time, in whatever value you want. Let's give it a try. Save and close. Press T. And as you can see, both decks decreasing and increasing. Now, if you want to change the mode to only when you press the button, you have to change the script and replace the word toggle with the phrase while pressed. Of course, you can tweak the volume and the speed as you like again. Save, close it, and let's give it a try. Now, it actually works only when I have pressed the button. If I release it, it goes up again. Now, before the pro tip I promised you, make sure to give some thumbs up, subscribe to my channel and turn on that ring bell, so you are the first one to know when I upload anything new. Also, let me know in the comments below which method do you prefer and why. Pro tip.
No! God, please, no! 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 God! No! 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 God! No! No!
We all have mics, and we plug them in the mic input of our controller. And it's not bad, but you can have much better quality and more control over your mic and your overall sound by using a small mixer just like this. For real, even with a minimum budget of 60 euros, you can level up your game with the mic and your overall sound. Plus, you have some empty inputs to plug in whatever you are going to need, like second microphone, a smartphone for requests maybe, the master output of a band who plays before you, and many more. Boom! That was it for today. Thanks for watching. Let me know in the comments below which mixer do you prefer to use and why. Subscribe to my channel and turn on the ring bell, and see you in the next one.